Hey folks, Battle Mode here. I'm going to play something a little bit different today, and it's not going to be the start of a new series. I don't think I'm going to have time to play it all the way through, but I wanted to show this off. It's really, really cool. Before I tell you about this, I'm going to tell you a little bit of the backstory, and I'm going to try and do it as briefly as possible because I think it's interesting. And for those of you who kind of don't know much about how like YouTube channels are run and stuff, it might be interesting to you to hear this. I don't really particularly care about the business side of YouTube, to be honest with you. So I'll talk about this stuff. So I'm primarily a strategy gaming channel, as you know. I mostly play strategy games on here. Every now and again, like if I'm doing a live stream or something, and I'll just play something else. Like I was playing a first-person shooter the last time I did one of the live streams I did. And I play all sorts of things. I've just bought Tekken 8, which is a beat-em-up, and I've been a big Tekken fan ever since the very first game on the PlayStation. Was it PlayStation? I think it was. So I've played like all of the Tekken series. I'm really, really into it. Like I've got an arcade stick. I play with Tekken 7, I was playing quite competitively at one point. I was ranking quite high. So I really, really like all kinds of games. I play everything pretty much. One of the only genres of games that I don't really play is survival games. This is a survival game, okay? And it's a very interesting one. But I don't play survival games generally because they're just a bit too time consuming. Like all my buddies back home from where I'm from that I grew up with, those guys, they all play survival games. They love them, and they'll spend all weekend hanging out, and they'll be sitting there drinking on Discord, chatting to each other while they're playing these games. And I just don't really have the time for it, even though I think they're really cool. I can't play them for too long because I have to play them all day if I'm going to play a game like that, and I just don't have time. So I don't play survival games as a rule. The second part of this story is that I, as a YouTube channel with, you know, several thousand subscribers now, I do get keys sent to me by PR firms. I'm constantly getting like either keys or marketing materials, and most of them I think kind of like vet you first to see who you are and what kind of channel you are, but I think a lot of them don't, or they're really, really loose. So 90% of the stuff that gets sent to me I just don't cover. And part of the reason for that is I used to feel obligated to cover stuff if people sent it me. And then after I did a review of, well, you know, I played, I think it was Pegasus Expedition, which I thought was cool, but it just wasn't really my kind of game. And I felt obliged to do it. And I don't think that the video really conveyed, it wasn't helpful neither to the developer, to the PR firm, or to my channel, because I clearly wasn't very enthusiastic about it. I rushed through it, I didn't really want to do it, and it just made the game look worse than it was, because actually Pegasus Expedition is a really good game, by the way. I just didn't really get on with it at that time. So I said to myself after that, I ain't going to do any more, you know, like I'm just not going to accept any more Steam keys, you know, or game keys for games that I don't want to cover, because I feel that it's not fair on the developer. It's, you know, because they're, you know, because I'm taking advantage by taking a free game and then not really doing much with it. So I politely declined, and I was like, I'm ever so sorry, I don't really play this kind of game. It does look kind of cool. And the developer replied, actually, and it wasn't a PR firm, and I was like, oh, it's actually the developer I'm talking to. And he was like, oh, no, it's very magnanimous. And he was just like, oh, no worries. Like, I appreciate, you know, you appreciate your time. And so I thought, well, you know what, I'm going to have a look at this game. So I did actually, I actually bought myself a copy because I was like, you know, I'm not going to promise to cover this. And then I played it and I was like, actually, this is really good. And the graphics are amazing on it as well. And this is an indie developer, right? I think this is just one developer. This is one guy. So I thought I'd at least show the start of the game because I think it's really cool and I want you to see it. And yeah, so let's go. This is a game called Above Earth. I'm not going to talk too much about what it is. Let's just play. But essentially, it's a survival game set in a space station. So we're going to set. I'm just going to go with the Earth Orbit A. I don't know enough. Like, there's not really a lot of information on the game anywhere. And I get the impression it's probably the sort of game that you want to just play and not really look at any spoilers. So I'm just going to pick the Earth lunar orbit. So we're going to be in a space station that's just orbiting around Earth, basically. I'm going to leave it all on the very, very preset settings. Apparently the game's really difficult, but that's absolutely fine for us for this thing. So we're just going to generate this station. It looks like it procedurally generates a new station each time. There we go, look. And the graphics are really, really nice in this, I think. There we go. So we got our station. And we get a nice little intro cutscene.
Copy that.
Look at these graphics for an indie game, man. They're really, really nice.
Copy that. Looking at it now.
Whoa. And the space station just got hit by a missile. That's really cool. It's like you kind of black out as well. They can see the dark side of the planet here. Some very, very concerning looking lights on the planet. Okay, so we've got to get back to the look at this. This is Earth look, and there's some rather alarming looking lights. I tell you, right, when I first saw this, it kind of spooked me out, because I grew up in the 80s, okay, and as a kid, the big fear in the 80s was a nuclear war, right? It was the height of the sort of Cold War. Well, it was coming out the end of the Cold War, I'd say. The height of the Cold War was probably earlier than that, but still. And so nuclear war was a terrifying thing that, like, everybody was always talking about. The news was always banging on about it. And yeah, so we got these crazy, crazy explosions going off on the surface of the planet. And this, when I actually played this, it really, really freaked me out a bit. Now we're actually in a suit, and we've got a little. You can see the speed on the right. Look, we are actually heading towards the space station. So we've been. Yeah, look, there's more explosions going off now. So there's something dreadful going on the planet Earth. It looks like there's a nuclear war going on, and yeah. Really, really scary and horrifying. We're going to try and make our way back to this, to the space station. You can see all the debris around the space station where it clearly got hit by some kind of missile. So perhaps, you know, yeah, look at this. Now, I don't know if that's some debris there. Plate that's just catching the light. It's coming off that space station. More explosions going off. Yeah, so we're going to try to try not to use too much fuel, because we've only got a limited amount of fuel and a limited amount of oxygen, and we are heading quite fast towards this space station. Now, we want to check out any of this junk on the way. Maybe we do. Maybe we do. Let's see what we can find here. This might be a really bad idea, by the way, guys, because you have very, very limited resources. It's a resource survival game, I guess. You want to see if there's any of this junk. I don't know if we're going to be able to collect any of it. It might be just worth seeing what it is. Oh, we're going to be way too fast. Way too fast. You've got to kind of, like, I'm using the WASD keys to kind of control the thruster here. And we want to slow down, because we don't want to hit this junk fast, because we might injure ourselves. There we are. Let's just bring ourselves to slow down a little bit. What is this stuff? Can we grab it? EVA is an acronym that stands for extra vehicular activity. It can be very dangerous, especially without a support system. Now, I don't know if I can do anything with this. There we go. Look, we stopped. Let's see if we can get a little bit closer. Ooh. Now, this is quite a slow game. It's a slow and kind of careful paced game, and it's really, like, it's really, really yeah, I don't think I can do anything with that. I think we've got to get straight to the station, but we should remember that there is a load of junk out here and we might need that later. Let's just get out towards the station anyway. So yeah, just kind of go back to what I was saying. Like, I don't normally cover other games, but I think I'm going to start covering some other games on the channel, other types of stuff. I'm always going to be playing strategy games for the most part, folks. Like, that's what I cover. But there's nothing to stop me from occasionally showing off some other stuff. And yeah, there's the Earth look. Look at this. This is really cool. This is really, really nice production for an indie game, by the way, guys. Especially a solo developer. Like, when I saw this, I thought to myself, ah, actually, look at this, man. This is really cool. Now, I think the game's been in development for quite a while. I don't know very much about the game, in all honesty, other than what I was kind of reading on the Steam forums. Even there's not a whole lot of information. Okay, I'm going to stop rotating. There we are. And just bring ourselves close. Now, it's telling us where to go. We've got... Ah, is that another place we can enter as well? Now, here's our station, look. Okay, I'm just going to try to line myself up a little bit with this docking area, and we're going to get back into this space station. I need to slow down. Oh, there we go. In we go, look. Okay, so we're back in. Now, we can load ourselves some more fuel. It doesn't look like we've got any more fuel, though, at the moment. So, okay. What have we got here? There's a load of stuff floating around. Got a glow stick. Okay. Press F to pick up and interact things. Okay, we've got some spacesuits here, or people. I don't think they are people. And we've got an air tank, some water, oxygen candle, a vibro hammer. So let's pick up these items and just get them off the from floating around. Glow sticks, air tank, small fuel tank. There we go. Okay, there's a bunch of stuff. All right, I think we've got most of it. Looks like there's... is that a box? Let me just spin myself around. There we are. We got a tool battery. Let's grab that too. Try and orient ourselves. Or orient myself. Okay, so what do we got? We got some chemicals. I'm just kind of floating around here in zero G. Oops, that's what I want to do. Oh, I dropped it. It's F key. There we are. Okay, let's just pick up the cloths. Some chemicals. Now, this is a game that's got crafting in it. Now, I know I've gone on record for saying I really don't like crafting in games. I just want to clarify that statement, right? I don't mind crafting in video games, providing that it's supposed to be part of the game. I don't like it when they just shoehorn it into other stuff, like 4X games and stuff, generally speaking, unless it's a real significant part of the game. However, in these kind of games, these games are all about crafting, so I'm well into it in these kind of games. So what do we got? We got a drill tool. A pistol grip drill tool with various attachments used to repair complex equipment. We've also got a vibro hammer, powered hammer designed specifically for zero gravity environments. Okay, and we've got some water, an oxygen candle, an emergency source of high quality oxygen that also produces a lot of light. It's a single use item. Okay, it's also a light source. So we've got a whole bunch of stuff now. We've got our glow stick floating here. It's probably not going to last forever if I know glow sticks. I've been to raves, man. I know what they do. There's a hot pack as well. Okay, and a cold pack. Have we got all the goodies now? I think we probably have. So let's see what else we can do in here. Ah, module power switch. 1 HW required to turn on. Okay. So yeah, we need power. So what's through here? Got a door. Get a bit closer to it. Initiate pressurization sequence. Okay. Okay, this is going to take some time. So let's just go back to that. And let's see what we can do. We might be able to craft something to be able to help us. So now we've got a bunch of these items. We've got a sleeping harness here. Oh, here we can sleep, look. Exposure temperature plus or minus 7 degrees C. Fatigue recovery is not times 1.2. Warning, conditioner will not recover. Okay, so also, you might have noticed, but if we go to, where are we? Character. We've got a concussion. So you've experienced a collision involving the head. So use pain pills. And it's going to last for less than one day. And it gives you a bunch of... a bunch of modifiers, look. So everything's going to take longer, essentially. So we've got this concussion. It doesn't look like we've got any other damage. We've got a inventory, as you've seen. We've also got a, hold on, can we equip stuff? Oh, I see. Different items have got different context. Menu commands. Oh, you can recycle stuff as well. That's cool. Let's have a look at the journal. Okay. Day zero, 11 minutes. Station attacked. Condition added, concussion. Nuclear war begins. Oh dear. So it was a nuclear war. End EVA. So we actually got in about 2 minutes later. And then it's just telling us some of the stuff that we've done. So we've initiated the pressurization of the door. I think we've got to wait for that to finish. Now we can construct stuff and we can craft. I think construction is going to be large items. So we can make a sleeping harness, which we've already got, I think. We can make a toolbox too. We can make a container, a storage container, a large storage container, makeshift chem healer, a chem heater, and a makeshift chem cooler. Okay, now. So I'm assuming that we're going to go through situations where we're going to get warm and cold then, which makes sense if you're in space. We've got stuff. We've got materials, look. Now you'll see that we can actually carry 400 kilos and our inventory is up is about 100, just over 100 now. Let's just take a bunch of this stuff so that we can get access to some of the crafting recipes. Okay, we can make an emergency flare, wrist brace, ankle brace. Okay, so I'm assuming it's quite easy to get wounded in this game. We can make a hot pack and a cold pack, the glow stick, a glow pod, and an oxygen candle. Now, the glow pod, it says, a disposable light source that provides high-quality illumination. It's single use, but can be turned on and off to increase its useful life. Quick to craft. Let's make one of those. There we go. Okay. Oops. So let's hit the I key. Where's this glow pod? There. Okay, so let's equip that. Oh, there we go. Okay, so we can turn this one on and off now. We've actually got a glow stick at the moment, so we probably don't need this thing. Let's just see how that door is doing. Let's just press H to holster the item. 5%. Okay, so I think we probably what we want to do is maybe we want to try to. I didn't see anything that we could craft that looked particularly useful. We probably need to get through this door. Maybe we go out and do a little bit more EVA. Now, we can actually. We've got a small fuel tank, so we can actually load some more fuel. Don't have a lot, do we? Let's limit ourselves to
It's too
50%.
hot.
Oh. He's complaining about being hot. Okay, that's interesting. Maybe we go outside. Let's initiate EVA. Here we go. Okay, there we are. So we're now outside. Press tab and hold to display your HUD. During EVA, you can use your HUD to track objects visible near the station. Ah, look. So we've got cargo. Interesting. Standard fuel tank. Tokahashi is dead. Oh, so it sounds like we've lost somebody. Emergency container, large air tank. All right, so there's stuff that we can scavenge, look, out in space around the station. Earth looks kind of quiet. Let's see if we can find something that's quite close to us, and we'll see if we can pick it up. There's an emergency container, but it looks like quite a long way out. Survival kit. Supply. There's. Oh, hang on. Industrial cargo. Let's head out towards that. I'm going to be really, really sparing with my. Now, I'm just wondering, are we going to be in direct. Oh, yeah, there's the sun. We're right directly near the sun, look. I wonder if that's going to heat make us too hot. I'm sure we'll soon find out. Let's just speed up just a bit. Okay, we need to speed up more because it's going to take a long time otherwise. Okay. That's better. We're gonna have to be really, really sparing with the fuel that we've got. But I'm just gonna risk a little bit more speed. I think, right, this would be a really, really nice chill game. I mean, you know, the theme of it's actually quite dark, I guess. But with regard, but you know, actually as a survival game, it just sounds like a really chill game. Press M when your HUD is active to set the object you're pointed at as a target. This will allow you to track the object even when you're not viewed. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's nice. Middle mouse button to select sleep to get some rest. Oh, hang on. Let me just slow speed down. Okay. Now, I don't know whether industrial cargo is going to be anything particularly useful for us, but it's worth having a look at. Let's see what we can do once we get close to this thing. Here we go. See, I these are the sort of games, in my opinion, that you don't really want to be having too many spoilers with. I think you should probably try and figure them out for yourself. Now, let's just put this away. You will not regain fatigue while you're drifting. Okay, so drifting. Press middle mouse button and select sleep to get some rest. The sleep button will change to a drift button during EVA. You will not regain fatigue while drifting. I think this just speeds up some of the slow movement. Can we actually get into this cargo container? Okay, we don't want to go too far away. I love it. It's really, really cool. You have to use really precise controls to kind of get it in the place that you wanted to get it to. Okay, it looks like we've already got these tools equipped. Can we get into this thing? Nope. I don't think we can. All right. Let's just have a look to see if there's any kind of doorway on it or entryway. Likely, if it's industrial cargo, it feels like something that we're probably not going to be able to open ourselves. Oh, sorry, I keep talking, you know, as if talking about we, and I do that basically in strategy games because, you know, I think I feel like we're playing it together, right? So if that sounds really, really strange, just let me know. Let's see what else we've got around here. We've got a survival kit over there. We've got supply cargo. There's a standard fuel tank. The fuel tank might be worth grabbing. We've got 42 fuel left. Some debris. Supply cargo. I think I'm going to go for the air tank and the fuel tank. They sound like they're probably really important for us to get. So let's just... There we go. And let's head towards these. I've played a few of these kind of games, these space games. I think I had one in a VR game as well. I can't remember what it was called now. I had... Was it Detached? Something like that. And that was kind of an interesting game as well. But this isn't solo dev, man. This is really cool. Some really nice graphical effects in it. Okay. Let's get a little bit closer to this thing. Yeah, we can press drift. Okay, we don't want to do that. I don't think we want to drift for an hour. That might be too long. And sleepy battle mode will wake up and he'll be drifting out into space with no way of getting back. I watched the trailer for the game, and the trailer, you know, it makes a big thing about the fact that deep space is probably the most inhospitable, you know, it's the most inhospitable environment that humans have survived in. And that's got to be right. I mean, I think there might be an argument to be said that the deep undersea as well is really, really crazy too. But I mean, I've got, you know, the astronauts that go up to these space stations, man, that's like, it's absolutely mental. You can't even, and I guess until you've like done a bit of research on it, which I haven't done a whole lot, to be honest, you can't even comprehend how difficult it is to live out there. These astronauts have to be super fit as well. Super fit. Okay, here we go. Try and get ourselves into the same kind of velocity as this thing. Oh, we're going way too fast. Okay. Okay, do not panic. Don't panic. The last thing you want to do is panic. I've done scuba diving once. That's like the closest thing I can think of to this. Like, don't panic, whatever you do. Okay, here we go. Did we get it? F. No, no. Okay. Close. Let's get close. Get closer. 3 meters away. Okay, we've got the air tank. Oh, it's a large air tank, so we've got 10 litres of air. Okay. And now, I'm sure that there was some fuel around here too. Fuel tank. Very large air tank. Industrial cargo. I'm sure there's a fuel tank around here. There's a large fuel tank there. Do we want to go that far? It's like a kilometer away. Was there another one closer? I thought there was. Potoshimi, dead. Wow. We should probably go and investigate the body of our... I assume he's probably one of our comrades. Okay, another very large air tank. I think it's going to be that fuel tank. I think we probably want the fuel. Wow, orienting yourself in space is really not easy. Okay, there's the large air tank. There's a very large air tank. There's a survival kit. A survival kit might be worth grabbing as well, but I think we want the fuel. Forgive me, folks. I've got hyper-focus issues, so sometimes passing large amounts of data can be a little bit confusing. Survival kit. Just do a cargo. Wreckage debris. Now, later on in the game, we're going to get some stuff, I think, that will... Oh, there we go. There's the standard fuel tank. Well, there's one of them. Well, there was one closer than that, though. Okay, I don't see it there. Let's just go for that one that I just saw. Oh, there we go. Standard fuel tank. Got it. 300 meters. I knew that there was one closer. Okay, let's just get... It's 300 meters away. Wow. So, really, just going out to grab these items that we've got has taken a fair amount of fuel. I think we're going to have to make it a priority for us to try to get some more fuel early, because it looks like maneuvering is going to be the thing. And obviously, like, if you got all the time in the world, right, you could probably just sit here and float and, you know, just be quite happy floating. The problem is that you do need to drink, and yeah, you do need to drink and you need to eat, I think. So we are eventually going to run out of food. Apparently this game is quite difficult. That's one of the things that I've heard about it. God, you'd feel so lonely, wouldn't you, up here? I don't know why. It reminds me of Space Oddity by David Bowie. Okay, so we're getting a little bit closer. Let's just speed this up just a little bit. There we go. So you use the space key to kind of move yourself up. You know, kind of... strafe up, I guess, and the C key to take you down slightly. Okay, let's start slowing down here. Wow, this is crazy. Now, is this going to be fun viewing for you guys? I don't know. Wait, too fast battle mode. Come on, right, that's it. Come on. There we go. There we go. Standard fuel tank. If the fuel level gets too low, it may not be possible to return from EVA. EVA suits can be reloaded with fuel tanks in the EVA port. Let's go. So we need to get back now. We need to refuel our EVA tank. Let's just go back to the station. I'm going to hit that. And there's the EVA port. Look. Now, is there anything on the way? Because we probably want to be thinking about efficiency in a game like this, right? I don't see anything that is that close. There's debris, but I don't think we can do much with debris. Ah, there's another large fuel tank. Oh, okay, we've ended up with concussion. Let's just head back to the EVA, and we're just going to... Now, we need to make sure that we leave ourselves enough fuel to be able to manoeuvre back into the EVA port. And I'm really, really interested to see what is behind that door in that space station when I get there, because I don't know how long that's going to take to open, but we definitely need to sleep at some point. I think we've got enough food and water to be able to do so. Wreckage there, just floating by us. Supply cargo. Is that worth grabbing, I wonder? We grab that, guys? I think we should. Let's try. So we're changing our velocity, or changing our relative direction. I'm sorry, I don't really know all the correct terms. I've not played enough Kerbal Space Program. God, that's a good game, by the way. I don't know if any of you folks... I'm sure... I know I've got a lot of fans here who also like Daz Tactics channel. And Daz really likes Kerbal. And I got really, really into Kerbal Space Program for about... probably about 20, 30 hours. I thought it was absolutely brilliant. But I'm not very good at it. Like, for somebody who did a maths-based degree, I just really do not like doing maths very much. I didn't do it out of choice, put it that way. Okay, here we go. Yeah, let's get this supply cargo. Let's see if we can grab this supply cargo. No more explosions on Earth. Maybe everyone's dead. Maybe there's been a ceasefire. Let's hope so. That's funny. It's like... I was talking to my missus about this, and she was like, "I hope when England got nuked, they got Nottingham." She doesn't like Nottingham very much. Oh, okay, we're very low on fuel. Ooh, I might have made a big error here, guys. Okay, I'm going to try and get this supply cargo anyway. So, can I even get this? We have to be really, really careful with our fuel now, getting back. Okay, we got a whole bunch of stuff, look. We got no tool to grab it, to get it. Okay, but look what's in here. We got cloth, food, battery, tool battery, coffee grounds, cable, garbage. Finish salvaging. Yeah, we didn't manage to get anything out of it. Do we need a tool? Let's grab some food and water. See, I don't know if we need the tool to open it or not. We might find that it won't let us do this. I don't garbage. Or do I? Suppose we can take a bit to see what it does. Okay, we got these sliders we can actually manually move. Oh, no. Too much stuff. Okay, we don't want to take too much stuff. Let's get rid of the stuff that we do not need. Oh! Sleep deprivation. But we are getting some stuff out of here.
I'm thirsty.
Okay. Cancel. Let's just cancel that because it looks like we're in trouble. So I'm going to open this. Okay, so our inventory, we want to get some water. We've just taken some water and we've taken some food. Oh, right, we can't take anything. Well, we can't eat or drink anything. Of course we can't. How do we get it into our mouths, silly Ben? So let's, I think what we're going to do is, since we look like we're in big trouble, let's get back to the space station. Now, we know where this supply cargo is. Holy crap, where is the space station? There it is. Don't lose the space station, guys. Here we go. Okay, I'm just going to take it. That's it. That's all I can afford myself. Man, this game's great. I like it. I really, really like it. If you reach the point of no return, you may be lost in space forever. Yeah, we don't want that. Excuse me. Wow, things are looking a bit dire, guys. We've got sleep deprivation. I wonder if we put ourselves on drift now, would that help? Maybe not. There we go. Okay. It's actually drift, but our conditions deteriorated. I think we probably should just risk a little bit more gas. Oh, it's tense. Look at this. I'm starting to, he's starting to trip out. Oh my god. It's full of stars. Open the pod bay doors, Hal. Open the pod bay doors. No, I'm not even going to go there. Shut up, Ben. Wow, look at this. I love how the graphics change. This is really neat. And this looks really, really... I don't know if you've ever had an ocular migraine. This looks like it looks like he's having an ocular migraine, which is probably quite likely. Fuel's really, really low. Oh. Tension. We're going to have to get around the side of this. I don't know if you guys remember the original version of Elite. Do you remember that game? On the BBC Micro, I think it was. Okay. Oh no. We are right out of fuel, guys. We got to get this right now. Got to get this right. We're out of fuel. Did we make it? Are we going to make it? Come on. Here we go. F. Initiate. Oh, we got in. Oh, with no fuel left as well. Okay, we need... Let's get some light on the subject. Okay, now, in we go. We don't need no fuel here. Our glow stick's still going, look. Not giving off much light, though. Very, very realistic. The rave is over. Okay, let's get... let's see if we can eat some food. Probably want to drink water first, eh? We remove the dehydration. And we want to eat too. We managed to salvage a whole bunch of stuff there. Air quality is bad. Okay, let's get the oxygen candle out. Okay, the oxygen candle is going to give us some light. It's also going to improve the quality of the oxygen in the place. If condition gets to zero, death will follow. Sleeping in a sleeping pod without any survival deficiencies will recover condition. Some medical items may also improve condition. We're not doing good, folks. Let's see if we can craft anything that might help us. No. So we probably... Do we need to sleep? Yeah, we're really fatigued. Heat's going up. I think we'll be alright. Let's get 8 hours sleep. Conditions improving. Oh, hypothermia. It's hot.
It's too hot.
Okay. Yeah, we do not want hypothermia. So let's get a cold pack here. Let's use that. Okay, where's the... There's the harness. Is that going to be enough to help us, do you think? Warmth's going up still. Condition will not recover. Alright, so the reason being is because it's too hot. Do we need to use another one of those packs? Okay. Oh yeah, that's better. Now we can... Yeah, condition recovery times 3. Let's just try and recover our condition. Because we're not doing too good. All thirst's not good now. Yikes. Wow, we got any water? Oh no, we don't have any water. We might be in trouble, folks. We might be in trouble. Is there any water in any of these areas? I don't think there is. What do we got? A material, mechanical parts, tool battery, glow stick. No water though, eh? Hmm. Maybe we should have tried to find some water first. Can we get through the door yet? 80%. Okay, we're just going to try and raise our condition. Oh no, he's thirsty. Dehydration. Oh no, we're dying. Is there anything in any of these things that can help us? I think we might be dead, guys. We might be dead. Oh no. Can we drink the chemicals? I'll drink anything. Bleach, anything. Give me some bleach. My kingdom for a bottle of bleach. can we not use some of this stuff to make chemicals? Let's just see what we can do. Water. What do we need? We need dirty water and purification tablets. Okay. Water in Nivea drink bag. No, it's not looking good, is it? I think we probably spent too much time outdoors trying to... Yeah, we died. Oh no, it's game over. Yeah, so I did read on the Steam forums and then on the reviews that this game is quite difficult. Let's send Steve some feedback. I like it, but it's really difficult. Don't change it. Don't change the difficulty. Because I like difficult games. Yeah, I don't know if that's useful information or not. Anyway, folks, this is Above Earth. I actually really like this. This is great. I want to play it some more. So I might actually try, when I've got some time, I might come back to this one and play it again. Now, this is just the start of the game, by the way. I've probably not really showed off very, I've probably not shown off much of, you can get inside the station, and when you get inside the station, it opens up a whole new load of stuff as well. So this is like a proper sort of, excuse me, this is a proper survival sandbox game, and there's a lot to it. There's loads of different station types, I think, and, you know, cool stuff that you can do with it, and things that you can build. So this is just the very, very start. I hope you enjoyed that, and let me know if you want to see more of this kind of content on the channel. Thank you, let me just remind myself of the gentleman's name, Steve Boyette. Thank you, Steve, for sending for offering the key. I really do appreciate it. Like, the game looks really, really cool, and I'm definitely want to play it again. So yeah, thanks for that. I think it's really good for me as well to actually play stuff that's outside of my purview. I can't just play Shadow Empire and Dominions and stuff, and Galsiv all the time. It's good to get out and check out other games and just see what other indie developers are doing, because, look at this, man. This was made by one guy, and we've only just scratched the surface. And it's really, really beautifully presented. Like, that intro is really cool, man. I thought it really hit me quite hard, seeing all those nuclear explosions going off on the surface of the planet while you're just floating in space with no, with a wrecked space station to go and fix. I thought that's really, really cool. Wonderful. All right, guys. I will catch you next time. Let me know what you think about the game in the comments. And, yeah, we'll talk soon. Take care.